Hello everyone, welcome to the channel Vidyut Yog. In this session, we'll see the demonstration of design and simulation of universal motor using Ansys Maxwell software, that is RMS PET tool. So before going to start the video, in case if you have not subscribed to this channel, I request all of you to do subscribe so that you will get the updates about latest videos uploaded under this channel. So without wasting time, we'll start with the demonstration. So what is the general procedure to design the universal motor using Ansys Maxwell software? First one, insert RMS PET design. I hope all of you might be aware about the RMS PET tool. For that purpose, I have uploaded the separate video, that is introduction to the Ansys Maxwell software, that is RMS PET tool. So you can go through that video. Then once you open the software, then what is the first step? Insert RMS PET design. Second, select the type of machine, that is universal motor as per the design requirement. Then third one, rename the project as per your convenience. Fourth step, provide the inputs needed to design the geometry of selected motor, that is to design the geometry of universal motor. Once you have given the input or prepared the geometry, then add a solution setup. In this step, we'll give the major technical parameters of the universal motor as an input to the solution setup. Then sixth, analyze all. So analyze your design, and if there is any error, then rectify that error. Then seventh step, validate the design. That is, before going through the results, make sure that you need to validate your design, and if there is any error, then you need to rectify that error. Then eighth step, right click on the solution setup and open the design sheet. So here the design sheet is nothing but the design sheet generated after your simulation. And then last one, download design sheet. So we'll start the demonstration of this design and analysis work for the universal motor. So for that purpose, what is the first step? First of all, you need to add the or insert RMS PET design. So for that purpose, if you go here, there is shortcut to insert RMS PET design. So in case of the insert RMS PET design, you can go through the different machines list for which you can make your RMS PET design, or you can design and simulate those machines with the help of the Ansys Maxwell software, like adjust speed synchronous machine, then brushless permanent magnet DC motor, clock pole alternator, DC machine, generic rotating machine, then line start permanent magnet synchronous motor, permanent magnet DC motor, single phase induction motor, then switch reluctance motor, three phase induction motor, then three phase non-silent synchronous machine, three phase synchronous machine, then universal motor. That means we can simulate the conventional motors as well as special purpose machines. So here, since we are going to design and simulate universal motor, that's why we'll select the universal motor, and once you select, then enter OK, so that motor will be available on the left hand side. See, this is the motor which is available on the left hand side. Okay, and in this you can select your project. Okay, in this project, whenever we are going to we will go through this project, see, there are different options for the design input, like machine, then in case of the machine, stator, rotor, commutator, shaft, analysis, optometrics, results, etc. So what is the second step? Once you insert the RMS PET design, just right click on it, and then you can go through this design inputs. Okay, here you can rename your project as per your convenience. Okay, Once you rename the project, then you need to give the different design inputs like machine, stator, rotor. Okay, and these inputs are needed to prepare the geometry of the motor. Okay, once you prepare the geometry, then you need to analyze that geometry. Okay, for that purpose, what we'll do? I have selected already one project, so we'll go through that project for the design inputs. But make sure that whenever you are going to give the input in under this view option, the project manager, this option should be enabled. Otherwise, what happens? This information will not be visible. So those who are new, make sure that before starting, status bar and project manager, these options should be enabled, so that project manager will give the idea about this information, and show progress. This bar which is showing here at the bottom side, it will show the progress of your analysis. Okay, then what we'll do? In case of the RMSP design universal motor, once we added the project, now we'll go through this demonstration project. So once we see, when we insert the machine, then it will show like this universal motor. Just click on this plus button, then here the project name will be available. Then there are different options like machine for universal motor, the machine, then as per the subcomponents of the motor like stator, pole, winding, then rotor, in case of the rotor, slot, winding, commutator, shaft, these options, these submenus will be available. So once we double click on the machine, then there will be the option like machine type, universal motor. Okay, then the inputs which are needed to prepare the geometries will be available on the left hand side, and in description box the meaning of that technical parameter is available. Like in case of the number of poles, what is the meaning of this number of poles of the machine? So here we have given the input as number of poles are 2. Then frictional loss, that means the frictional loss measured at the reference speed, and that unit of that parameter is also given. Like here, suppose if we click, then there are different units are available. Okay, so among these you can select the unit as per your convenience, and then as per that unit you need to enter the magnitude here. Then windage loss. So what is the meaning of windage loss? The windage loss measured at the reference speed. So here we have assumed windage loss is 0 watt. Then again here you can select unit as per your convenience. Then reference speed. So what is the meaning of reference speed? The reference speed at which the frictional and windage losses are measured. So here we have considered that 12,400 RPM is the reference speed. Okay, so we have given the general machine parameters, then enter OK. So that parameters get entered. Then subcomponent under the machine part is stator. Just double click on the stator, then it will ask the design inputs which are needed to prepare the geometry of stator. So here also same, the parameters are given on left hand side, the description of each parameter is given on the right hand side, and unit is shown here. The first parameter is outer diameter. What is the meaning of outer diameter? Outer diameter of the stator core. So here 61.7 is the outer diameter of the stator core we have considered. Then overall width, that means overall width of the stator outer profile. So here also we have considered overall width is 61.7 mm. Then inner diameter, that means inner diameter of the stator core we have considered 36.5 mm. Then length, what is the meaning of length of the stator core? Sorry, length of the stator. Here it shows the length of the stator core, which is we have assumed that 33.35 mm. Then stacking factor, that is stacking factor of the stator core, it is always less than 1, suppose we have considered 0.95. and then steel type, See, when we double click on this parameter, then it will show the material list. What is the beauty of this software? You can select any material available under this material library. Okay, and you can check the performance of the machine. Okay, those who are working on the research related to the universal motor, suppose they want to check the performance of the motor by using the different materials, they can select these different materials and check the performance of the machine, and according to that they conclude which material is the best material for this simulation for your universal motor to improve the performance of the machine. Or those who are working on the material or development of the material for preparing the universal motor, then they can add the material here. See, here is the option of add material, but before that make sure that material information should be available in this tabular format, like name, location, origin, type of the material, relative permeability of the material, bulk conductivity of the material, magnetic porosity of the material, pore loss of the material, thermal conductivity of the material, mass density, then specific heat, etc. Then only you can add that material, so that material will be available in this list. Apart from that, you can view or add the materials. Okay, then clone material, remove material from the library, then export to the library. So these options are also available. Okay, that means here we can select the any material and we can check the performance of the machine. So here we have actually selected the M19_24G material. Just select that material and enter the OK, so that material will be available here. That means this steel type of the material we have selected to prepare the stator. Then enter apply and OK. Now what is the next step? We need to give the inputs related to the pole. So when we double click on the pole, then it will ask for the MRAS. What is the meaning of MRAS? Pole MRAS. So we have given the input as 0.65. Then offset. What is the meaning of offset? That is pole arc center offset from the stator pole, and it is 0 for uniform air gap. So 0 mm. Then pole width. What is the meaning of pole width? Pole minimum width. It is 13.8 mm. Then TY, that is yoke thickness. So what is the meaning of yoke thickness? What is the value of yoke thickness? We have given the 5.2 mm. Then TS. TS is nothing but short tip thickness, and the value which we have given is 1.2 mm. Okay. Then next parameter is R1. So what is the meaning of R1? So R1 is nothing but hole radius in pole, and when we drag here, it will give the information. It is 0 for no hole. That means if there is no hole, then you can write down the 0. So here we have written as 1.6. Okay. Then next parameter is R2. What is the meaning of R2? Pole side fillet radius. It is 1.5 mm. Okay. Then R3 is radius of the center of pole side fillet arcs. So it is 24.15 mm. Then R4 is radius of the shoe connecting arc. And it is 0 for auto design or linear connect. So here we have consider the 0. That means it is selected as auto design. Then R5, what is the meaning of R5? The inner radius of the screw hole in between two poles, that is 0 for non-hole. So we have given the input as 2.2 mm. Then R6 is the outer diameter of the screw hole in between two poles, and it is 0 for no hole. So we have considered that value as 5 mm. Okay, then enter OK so that we have given the inputs related to the poll. But apart from that, if you want the detail idea about those parameters like R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6 from the diagram, then you can refer this diagram. Okay, now winding. So in case of the stator winding, we need to give the technical inputs. The procedure is same. The parameters are shown on the left hand side, description is given on the right hand side. Okay, so insulation thickness. So what is the meaning of that? Thickness of the insulation between stator core and field winding. So that insulation thickness is 0.2 mm. Then end adjustment. So what is the meaning of that? One side end extended length. So it is 0 mm. Then parallel branches. What is the meaning of parallel branches? Number of parallel branches of the stator winding. So it is 1. Then turns per pole. What is the meaning of turns pole? Number of turns per pole. So 0 for the auto design. So I will just enter 0. Then number of strands. What is the meaning of number of strands? Number of strands, that is number of wires per conductor. And if we select 0, that means it will select the auto design. But we have given the number of strands 1. Then wire wrap. What is the meaning of wire wrap? Double side wire wrap thickness. It is 0 for auto pickup in the wire library. Since we have selected here wire wrap 0, that is it will auto pick up from the wire library. That's why wire size it is showing diameter 0 mm. But that is wire size is 0 for auto design. That means we have instructed the software to select this size of the wire automatically. But if you are interested, then you can double click on it. Here unit system is given. You can select, it is right now mm. Then wire diameter 0 means auto design. Otherwise if you want to select the any other wire size, then you can select. Then gauge, either you can select as auto gauge, that is automatically it gets selected, otherwise you can select from the available options. Okay, so here we have given it as auto. Okay, then enter OK, then press apply and OK. Okay, so that means we have given the inputs for the stator according to which the geometry is available here for the stator. Now next part is rotor. So double click on the rotor. So when we double click on the rotor, there are the different options like technical parameter and description. So first one, stator stacking factor. What is the meaning of stacking factor? Stacking factor of the rotor core. So here we have assumed it is 0.95. then number of slots. What is the meaning of number of slots? That is the number of slots of the rotor core. So here we have given the input as 12 stator slots for our machine project or universal motor for which we are going to make the design. Then slot type. So slot type is means slot type of the rotor core. That is we have selected the 4. And 4 means not number. Here the geometries are available for the different slots, like this is the slot number 1 geometry, this is the slot number 2 geometry, slot number 3 geometry and slot number 4 geometry. Here we have given this slot number 4 geometry. And the meaning of the technical parameters like BH0, BS1, HH0, HS1, HS2, then BS2, RS, for that you can refer this diagram. Okay, then outer diameter. So here just I will suggest that whenever you are going to design and simulate the motor using RMXpert tool, first of all theoretically design your motor so that all these technical parameters which are needed as an input to the geometry, to prepare the geometry, that should be with you. Then outer diameter, that is outer diameter of the rotor core. So here we have considered 35.5 is the outer diameter of the rotor core. Then inner diameter, that is inner diameter of the rotor core is 12.1 mm. Then length, so length of the rotor core, that is 33.35 mm. Then steel type, that is steel type of the rotor core, steel type of the material prepared to prepare the rotor core, it is similar to the selection of the steel type material for the stator core. Just double click on it, then the material library is available. Okay, then here there are the material filters also, like active design, product, all product, like for conductor, hysteresis, magnet material, steel material. So here right now we have selected M19_24G. In this material library also the material is available with different information like name, location, origin, type, relative permeability, bulk conductivity, magnetic porosity, core loss, thermal conductivity, mass density, specific heat. And here also you can view or edit your material or add material if you are working on the research related to the development of new material for universal motor. Then you can check the performance of the same machine with the same design parameters with the different material, and you can conclude the best material to improve the performance of universal motor. Okay, apart from that, view or edit material, add material, clone material, remove materials, export to library, these options are also available. So I enter OK. So we have selected the steel type of the material. Now skew width. What is the meaning of skew width? That is the skew width measured in slot number. So it is 0 mm. So I enter apply and OK. So according to our design inputs for the rotor, see, this rotor geometry is available. Okay. Now in case of the rotor, the another sub point is stator. Slot of the rotor. So for that slot of the rotor, here this diagram is available. The meaning of term BH0, BS1, BS2, RS, H0, HS1, HS2. For that purpose, you can refer this slot diagram. But when we double click on the slot, then it will ask again for those parameter values. So auto design. So if you want to make the auto design of the slots, you can just check this box. Then auto design. Which parameters will be automatically designed, like HS2, BS1 and BS2 for the stator. Then parallel tooth. So parallel tooth, design BS1 and BS2 based on tooth width. So we have checked this box for the parallel tooth. Then tooth width. What is the meaning of tooth width? Tooth width for the parallel tooth. So here we have given the value as 2.3 mm. Then HS0. So I have already informed you that you can refer this diagram. For the slot information, so here HS0. HS0 is 1.11 mm. Then HS1 is the slot dimension. HS1 we have given 1.2 mm. Then HS2, that is slot dimension HS2, we have given the input as 4.4 mm. BH0, that is slot dimension BH0, we have given the input as 2.5 mm. Then RS, that is slot dimension RS, we have given the input as 0.5 mm. Then we enter the OK. Okay, then we double click on the winding. So in case of the winding, if we double click here, you need to select the rotor winding type. So you can select either the lap winding or wave winding. So here we are having the different options, but we have selected the lap winding for the selected universal motor. Okay, then multiple number. What is the meaning of multiple number? It is 1, 2 or 3 corresponding to single, double or triple winding respectively. So here we have considered the single winding, that's why we have given the input as 1. Otherwise you can select the 2 or 3, but we have selected the 1 for this universal motor. Then virtual slots. So in case of the virtual slots, what is the meaning of virtual slots? So virtual slots are nothing but number of virtual slots per real slot. So here also you are having the options. You can, if you click on it, it will ask for 1, 2, 3 or 4. We have considered virtual slots as 1. Then conductors per slot. What is the meaning of that? Number of conductors per slot. And it is 0 for auto design. So we have considered conductors per slot 0. Then coil pitch. What is the meaning of coil pitch? That is coil pitch measured in virtual slots. So here we have considered coil pitch as 6. Then number of strands. What is the meaning of number of strands? That is number of strands, that is number of wires per conductor. And if we select 0, that means it is auto design. So right now we have entered the 0, that means it will automatically get selected. Then wire wrap. What is the meaning of wire wrap? Double side wire wrap thickness. So it is 0 for auto pickup in the wire library. So here we have selected wire wrap as 0.05 mm. Then wire size. If we double click on it, then see the 0 is for auto design. So right now we have given the input 0, that means auto design. But if you want, you can select the gauge of the wire as per your requirement. Then this gauge number with diameter of the wire, that information is available here. Okay, so for that purpose, what you need to do, while making the theoretical calculation, you need to predict the current. According to the current, you need to select the diameter of the wire, and according to the diameter, you can select the gauge number. So that is the actual correct procedure. Then enter apply, and then press OK. So we have given the input survey to the winding. Now we double click on the commutator. So in case of the commutator, the description is commutator type. So if you double click here, then you can select either cylinder type for the commutator or the pancake type of the commutator. So here we have selected the cylinder commutator, and hence we enter OK. Then commutator diameter. So what is the meaning of this commutator diameter size? So it is, we have selected given as input as 24 mm. Then commutator length, that is commutator length in mm or any unit. Here we have considered in mm, so we have given the input as 10 mm. And commutator insulation, what is the meaning of this? The thickness of the insulation between the commutator bars. Here we have given the input as 0.5 mm for this commutator insulation. That's why we enter all the values as an input, then enter apply and OK, so that information will be available. Now regarding the shaft, just double click on the shaft. If you want to check the performance with the help of the shaft, that is the shaft is made up of the magnetic material, then you can check the box. If you do not want to check the performance along with magnetic shaft, then you can keep that box blank or unchecked, and then enter OK. Okay, that means in this step we have given all the design inputs which are needed to make the geometry of universal motor, and according to that this geometry get prepared. Now once the geometry get prepared, what is the next step? Then you need to analyze your design. For that purpose, just right click on the analysis and add solution, enter on the add solution setup. But here I have already selected the setup, and once we double click on the setup, then it will ask for the major parameters or major technical parameters of the universal motor. So what are the general technical parameters? Like operation type of the machine is motor or generator, so it is a motor. Then load type is constant power. That is mechanical load type is constant power, or you can select the constant speed, constant torque, linear torque, fan load, according to the application for which you are going to design your motor. Or once you prepare the hardware model of the motor, what type of the loads for which you are going to use the motor, accordingly you can select the load type. Then rated output, that is rated mechanical or electrical output power. So here we have given the input as we are going to design the 100 watt motor. Then rated voltage, that is applied or output rated line to line AC RMS or DC voltage input. So here we have given the 120 volt rated voltage of the motor. Then rated speed, that is given rated speed of the machine at which we have considered the frictional loss and windage loss. So here we have considered 12,400 RPM motor Then operating temperature. So here operating temperature you are going to consider, or you need to consider according to the application and under which environment or under which climatic condition you are going to use that motor for a particular application. So here we have considered operating temperature 75 degrees Celsius, then we'll enter the OP. Now once the setup get prepared, then you need to analyze your design so that if there is any error, then you will get the idea before making the hardware model or before making the actual analysis of this machine. So just right click on the analysis, then there are option like analyze all. Just enter on it so that the analysis will be started. It will take certain time, but the progress of that analysis is available here under the show progress bar. But for showing that, you must ensure that under the view option you need to select the status bar. Okay, once simulation get completed, then it will show like normal completion of the simulation on server. That means simulation is normal, or there is no any unexpected, or there is no any parameter which is not within the acceptable limit. But make sure that if there is any error, then if there is any value which is not within the acceptable limit, then there will be error like solution have been invalidated. Okay, then you need to go through the corresponding error, you need to rectify the error, and then again you need to do the analysis. You need to repeat this procedure unless and until the normal completion of the simulation get completed, or the simulation should be completed without any error. Okay, then just click on the and after the analysis, just you need to validate your design. So for that purpose, here is the option, you can just click on this, then it will show the design parameters like design setting, machine analysis setup, optometrics. The meaning of each this green right mark, it indicates that your design is validated. That is, design is validated for design setting, machine analysis setup, optometrics. But if there is any error or if there is any unacceptable value in your design, then it shows error. For that purpose, just we'll see this demonstration. Here we have selected the machine, but we have not given any input. So when we select this project and we validate our design, then it shows the error like machine analysis setup. It is indicated by red cross mark. The meaning of this machine design and analysis setup parameters are not validated. Okay, I hope you got the meaning of this. So again, I will go to our main project for the demonstration. So here, if we select this machine, design is validated. That means our analysis get completed smoothly. The design is validated. So now what we'll do, we'll go through the result data sheet. For that purpose, just right click on the setup and then this performance design sheet, curves, export, create Maxwell design, create iSpeak design, these options get enabled when your simulation get completed. So just go through the click on the design sheet so that the overall design sheet or output of this simulation will get the interim of the design sheet. So which information is available in the design sheet? So this is the most important output, that is all the technical parameters or all the performance information is available under this design sheet. So in this design sheet, under the general data, which information is available, like rated output power in kilowatt, rated voltage, then frequency hertz, number of poles, given rated speed in RPM, frictional loss, then windage loss, brush displacement, one pair brush voltage drop, then type of load, operating temperature, etc. So this information is available for the general data. Apart from that, for the rotor data, information is available like number of rotor slots, outer diameter of the rotor, then inner diameter of the rotor, then type of the rotor slots. So here we have selected the fourth type. We have already discussed this point. So according to that fourth type rotor slot diagram, the parameters inputs like HS0, HS1, HS2, BH0, BS1, BS2, then RH. This information we get in the detailed design sheet. Then tooth, top tooth width in mm, bottom tooth width in mm, then skew width, that is number of slots, then magnetic shaft. We have not considered magnetic shaft, that's why it is showing as no. If we have checked that option, then it will show as S. Then length of the rotor core in mm, stacking factor of the rotor core, type of the steel, then design wedge thickness in mm, slot insulation thickness in mm, layer insulation thickness in mm, then end length adjustment in mm, number of virtual slots per slot, number of conductors per slot, type of the armature winding, multiplex numbers, coil pitch in virtual slots, number of wires per conductor, wire diameter in mm, wire wrap thickness in mm, number of parallel branches, then half turn length, slot area in mm square, net slot area in mm square, then limited slot fill factor. So this information is available. That means few of the parameters we have given as an input, and based on that information few of the parameters automatically get calculated, which is also available in this detailed design sheet. Then regarding the stator pole information available, like minimum air gap in mm, outer diameter, length of the stator, stacking factor of the iron core, type of the steel, then pole arc offset, then physical pole embrance, competitor pole embrance, pole width in mm, and other parameters, other pole dimensions like TY, RS, R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, for which we already discussed. According to the, you need to refer the pole diagram for meaning of each parameter. So this information is available. Then apart from that, regarding the stator winding or stator coil, information is available like pole insulation in mm, end adjustment in mm, coil turns per pole, number of parallel branches, number of wires per conductor, then wire diameter in mm, wire wrap thickness. So this information is available. Then commutator and brush data. In this, the type of the commutator, like we have selected the cylinder type of the commutator, or you can select the pancake type of the commutator. But right now here it is type of the commutator information is available. Then commutator diameter in mm, commutator length mm, commutator insulation in mm, brush width in mm, brush length in mm, then press per unit area in, then frictional coefficient. So this information is available under commutator and brush data. Then material consumption. So another beauty of this software is that before making the hardware model of the motor, you will get the material consumption in kg. So you can compare the current market rate for this material, and accordingly you can estimate the cost which is required to prepare the hardware model of this motor. So in case of the material consumption, the armature wire density in kg per meter cube, then field copper density in kg per meter cube, armature core steel density in kg per meter cube, stator core steel density in kg per meter cube, then armature copper weight in kg, field copper weight in kg, armature core steel weight in kg, stator core steel weight in kg, and total net weight in kg. Like for this case, it is 0.60 kg. Then armature core steel consumption in kg, stator core steel consumption in kg. So this information is available under the material consumption. Now non-saturated parameters like field winding resistance in ohm, field winding resistance at 20 degrees Celsius, field leakage inductance in millihenry, field self inductance in millihenry, then armature winding resistance in ohm, armature winding resistance at 20 degrees Celsius, armature leakage inductance in millihenry, armature self inductance in millihenry, then rotating voltage coefficient in millihenry, brush cover factor. So this non-saturated parameter information is available. Then motor full load operation data. See, although we have not prepared the hardware model, then also you can check the full load operation data of this universal motor. So what information will be available, like input current in ampere, armature thermal load, specific electric loading, then armature current density, field current density,
nutritional loss, iron core loss, copper loss, brush loss, then total loss, then output power, input power, and efficiency. So here right now it is 67.5, but we are just discussing the demonstration, so it will be okay. But as per your design, you can improve the input parameters, and accordingly you can observe the motor, or you can continue your analysis unless and until you will not get the efficiency till expected level. Then rated speed, rated torque, so this information is available. Apart from that, rotor tip flux density in Tesla, then rotary of flux density in Tesla, stator of flux density in Tesla, stator pole flux density in Tesla, air gap flux density, then rotor tip ampere turns, rotor yoke ampere turns, stator yoke ampere turns, then stator pole ampere turns, air gap ampere turns, then day axis saturation factor, P axis saturation factor, correction factor for the magnetic circuit length of a rotor yoke, correction factor of the magnetic circuit length of stator yoke, then other operational data like no load speed, no load current, no load input power, locking rotor torque, locking rotor current, maximum output power, then speed with maximum output. This information is also available. Then transient FEA input data like for armature winding, number of turns 636, parallel branches, terminal resistance, end leakage inductance, for one armature coil, number of turns, parallel branches, terminal resistance, end leakage inductance, then for field winding, number of turns, parallel branches, terminal resistance, then end leakage inductance, could equivalent values like equivalent model depth, equivalent stator stacking factor, equivalent rotor stacking factor, then estimate rotor inertia moment. So this information is available. Okay. Now, apart from that, if you click on this, then under the design sheet option only, there is option for performance. So all the design parameters which we have discussed in the technical design sheet are available here. Like under the FEA input data, this information is available. Then full load magnetic data, the total information is available. Then under the full load operation, this information is available. Then under the material consumption, this information is available. So all these parameters already we have discussed in the design sheet. But as per your requirement, if you want to quickly go through that parameters or specific parameters, you can select those specific parameters here, like non-saturated parameters, then other operational data, then rotor slot, then rotor winding. So this information is available here. Then under the curves, you can go through the different curves like armature rotor inductance, mutual rotating inductance. So here you can check the different performance curves, like then armature self inductance, mutual inductance curve, then normalized air gap flux density curve, power factor versus speed curve, input current versus speed curve, efficiency versus speed curve, output power versus speed curve, then output torque versus speed curve. So this information is available here. And if you want, for you can just right click on it, you can copy bitmap image, and you can directly import this image in terms of the import these curves in terms of the image form, and you can use it for your project research project work or for the research paper work. Then the design sheet, you can select this entire design sheet. You can just copy that and you can directly paste in the Word file. Okay. Now apart from that, so this is the information which we get under this analysis option or with the help of the armature design, you will get the detailed analysis of the motor. If you are directly interested in the curves, you can just directly click here. Then you can right click on the setup, and if you are directly interested in the performance, then you can see directly the performance. Then apart from that, if you are interested in the create quick report, like particular curve only, suppose the torque of the motor, then just you can enter here, you will get the output torque of the motor directly. So accordingly you can select the quick results. Then apart from that, you can convert this design into the Maxwell or into the Maxwell 2D or 3D form. So for that purpose you need to click on Maxwell, insert Maxwell design. Here you are having the two options, Maxwell 2D design and Maxwell 3D design. So if we double, for example, we select the, you can select any design as per your requirement and enter OK. For example, for the demonstration, I will give the idea about Maxwell 2D design. I have selected the Maxwell 2D design and I enter the OK. Then this design will be converted into the Maxwell 2D form. See, till now, although we are saying that the universal motor, but universal motor is having its supply circuit as well as motor. But under this RM Expert tool, actually we work on the geometry of the motor and check the performance of the motor before making the hardware model. But if you want to work on the supply circuit like converter and controller part, for that purpose you need to work in the simplorer. Okay. But whenever you make your RM Expert design, then by default supply circuit is available according to which your performance of the motor is checked. So when we convert the our design into the Maxwell 2D design, you will get idea about that supply part also. So it will take so certain time to convert this design into the Maxwell 2D design. And once you convert your RM Expert design into the Maxwell 2D design, then you can check the supply circuit also, the diagram of the supply circuit and the information about the parameters related to the supply circuit. Okay. And similar for Maxwell 3D design, you can convert into the Maxwell 3D design. But then you prepare the Maxwell 2D design or Maxwell 3D design, then for checking the performance or for analysis purpose, you need to go through the certain procedure like selection of the boundary, selection of the excitation, selection of the parameters, selection of the mesh operation. So for that purpose, I have separately uploaded the video, that is Maxwell 2D design and Maxwell 3D design analysis of the induction motor, under this channel only. So you can go through that channel and you can understand the procedure for the analysis of 2D and 3D model. So I again request, if you have not subscribed this channel, just subscribe this channel so that you will get the idea about latest videos which will be uploaded from me. Okay, so now Maxwell 2D design model is available. Okay, so when we click on the Max circuit, then it will show the supply circuit which is available for this motor. So here I have click on the Max circuit. So this supply circuit is actually available for your motor according to the your design input. Okay, then once you do the analysis, then the torque, current, induced voltages, flux linkages, this information also you can obtain from your Maxwell 2D design analysis, and same from Maxwell 3D design analysis. Okay, so thus we, in this demonstration video, we have discussed about how to make the RM Expert design and analysis of the your motor, how to convert that motor into the 2D design and 3D design, how to check the max circuit information. If you are really interested in making the converter and controls for this motor, then you need to work in the simplorer. But if you want to play related to the geometry of the machine, or by checking the performance of the machine by using the different material, you can work with the RM Expert design. Okay, so I think this information might be helpful for you. Then very best luck for your research work or for your learning process. So again I request, if you have not subscribed this channel, please subscribe this channel so that you will get the idea about latest videos uploaded under this Vidyut Yog channel. So thank you all of you. Take care. Bye bye.